30 of the second day of the game, you meet up, gathering together in the Lord's Borough, which is where a number of fancy houses are built up. Just so you understand, it's where the minor lords, which are less than baronets or barons, live. And some of these houses are owned by wealthy merchants instead of actual people with title or land. So that said, you assemble. And just outside the house, you would see it would look like a house. Handout's not popping up for some reason. Give me, let me just try and force it here.
Take your time.
There you go.
Oh,
that's very eerie. Creepy old house with a bunch of weird kind of rubbly tree nonsense. The path leading up to it's kind of dirty. It's amidst the other homes. There's a bit of distance between it and the others, but just a creepy old house. All right. You kind of see that there isn't much to the house. It does look like all the windows are boarded up. And it does look like it is seeing better days. And in addition to that, just outside of the house, you can see that there's kind of like a pile of rubble, just stone, old stone that was probably being moved or manipulated to kind of build something, but was just kind of left. And sitting on that is an old man. With a blue cloak, strange-looking staff, and on a higher bit of rubble kind of near him, there's a bird that's kind of fluttering its wings dry. It's not raining. It's kind of like it just passed like a light drizzle, but the bird's kind of like, you know, nuzzling itself and like drying itself. It looks like a really pretty bird, but the old man appears to be having a conversation with it.
Gavin, you get down from there right now, boy. I don't have time for this. Gavin, listen to me.
I missed you.
The bird kind of flutters and sits to perch on top of the haunted house.
Damn it, Gavin! You get down here this instant!
So, as you guys kind of mass there, you're really not very visible to him. And there isn't much light that you're going off of, just from the road aside. It's kind of a dark place. But that said, I'm going to go ahead and start with Dieter.
Yes.
You basically have, you know, spoke to the other individuals here well enough to kind of understand who they are.
Uh-huh.
And, yeah.
Hold on, I'm setting my macros. A macro. Okay. I approach the house. Is the door locked?
So the door is looks like it's barred and boarded up, and so do the windows. You are passing by the old man. Cardiff, he passes close enough that you can kind of see him. He's a shadowy figure in a hood, and it looks like he has strange kind of appendages growing out of the top of his head. Appendages or horns or something.
Okay.
You just something. There's things growing out of the top of his head. You don't know if they're horns.
Okay.
They're definitely horns. I am a demon.
They are so horns.
I'll strut around the building nonchalantly, looking for other ways in. Perhaps windows that are low enough to get to easily. Maybe a cellar door or anything like that.
So as stated, the windows do look like they've been boarded up, that's like throughout. As you're kind of circumnavigating the house, which is what I'm presuming you're doing, you notice that, let's see here, bear with me, I'm just pulling up my notes. So the road kind of turns into a dirt road, passes up to it. When you come up to the door is locked. It looks like there are windows set in the doors, the front doors, but those you can see the boards through. And you can't really see past the boards. They're pretty tightly sealed together. To the right of the door, just off the like the little path, there's a gravestone and a mound. The gravestone reads, Zacchus Merrick, town guard of Hilton, died in the line of duty, scared by ghosts. And you kind of understand that it's kind of a set there as like the guy died there, sure, but more of kind of a warning to
scaring people away from the house.
Possibly, it could very well be that that's the sole intent. So from that position, you can kind of go towards the right of the house, which would be the west, or you can go to the left of the house, which would be the east. Which would you like to start?
I will look east first.
Okay. So you kind of walk the long route, and as you kind of move, past some windows and the like, you come to where the house ends and this large stone wall begins. The stone wall kind of extends off of the property, off of the building, about 15 feet. It's about 12 foot high, and it looks like there's brambles and like ivy that have kind of like interweaved over it and kind of dangle off of the edge of the wall like horrid witch's fingers. The door looks like it's pretty much sealed in by those, but you're pretty sure someone handy with a hatchet or a blade might be able to cut it free if you wanted to open that door. It does not look like it's been barred. And then when you come around that corner, there's a bit of a thicket, like if you were to head south down along that wall. But the wall runs all the way down the length of the property. You kind of move through, the bushes, kind of hopping over this little bit of a ridge or rock that's kind of grown up out of the ground. Not a very large one, just a little cairn, and kind of make your way towards the back of the property. Before you can kind of round to the back end of the property, there's a very large hedgerow that's been put up. It looks like it's been trimmed and maintained, so you're presuming that whoever's on the other side of this property has been kind of keeping this, line between properties clean so that, things don't grow over into their property.
Sure.
And you can see up over the 12-foot wall in the backyard of the property you're looking at, there's a very large dead tree, and it looks like it's basically covered with brambles, and it's basically being it looks like it's been strangled by these ivies and brambles. Do you want to go through the hedgerow to the other property on the other side, or do you want to just kind of go back the other way?
Double back the way I came.
Okay.
Can I ask a question?
Well, go ahead. I was actually going to, as Dieter's doing that, move to the next person, but yeah.
I'm kind of with Dieter, so I'd be following him, and honestly, I'm going to stop him and say, I can open these, no problem at all. To Glory's through this door, we might as well go in the front door.
Yes, Dugat, but can you open them quietly?
Why quietly?
You scream.
We're going to battle. It doesn't need to be quiet. We need to scream our shouts to our gods and go for the glory of ourselves and our future.
Certainly, yes. Glory to the gods and glory to ourselves, but people are sleeping and we don't want to wake them up with all of our glory.
Fine. I'll follow you. Your lead for now.
I certainly appreciate the offer and I will keep it in mind, but if I can find a quieter way in, let us find glory playing ghosts rather than knocking down doors.
Okay. So Dugat and Malcolm kind of move around to the east side of the building. While that's happening, Aramil, just again presenting what's happening, those two are kind of heading off that way. You're probably approaching up in kind. There's a strange old man who's kind of yelling up at the house. It sounds like he is yelling, but he does seem to appreciate the seriousness of his environs. Like he might have been told to keep it down before. So he's kind of like, get down from here! Get down right now! It's not actually him being yelling and boisterous. He does seem to have been reprimanded in his yelling. So he's yelling, but he's not, yelling. Does that make sense? And Dan, is that fine? Or are you trying to...
Yeah, that's probably fine.
The guards have come over and told you to shut up before.
So. Oh, yeah.
I figured he'd probably already woken up the whole neighborhood by now, so...
That was a couple nights ago.
I walk over to him quietly, and I kind of keep surveying the area and keep a lookout while they're exploring for entrances, and walk up to the old man and ask him What is it that you're doing out here at this hour of night?
Oh, hello. My bird here. Gavin, he's... Yeah, we seem to have gotten to a disagreement. And, here. Well, you see...
He waggles his quarterstaff up at the bird, beckoning him.
Gavin! Get down here!
The bird just kind of looks down at you.
What kind of disagreement?
Well, it was regarding a certain appetizer that we were both eyeballing, and I happened to be quite peckish myself, and... Well, you see... Get down here!
He starts trying to.
He starts like the cock of the walking. Building. He like starts cock of the walking across like the shingles and looks down at you and like does one of those.
You turkey!
Hard to believe that you, sir, could be more peckish than the bird himself.
I haven't been eating a whole lot.
As you get closer to the old man, you notice that he looks rather disheveled. His garb is actually quite soiled. He smells rather foul. If you've been around the city quite a bit, you might have seen him just kind of on the streets. He's kind of unpleasant to be around just by smell and appearance. He's got tears all through his garments. His nails are just like claddened with like dirt.
He's sickly. Long and short, yeah. And he's also poor. Yeah.
I don't quite trust the old man, so I'll just kind of hang around here for now and keep an eye out and keep the other eye on him.
Okay. And then that would go to Andy. What is Shadow doing while this is all going
down? Yeah, Shadow is definitely going to stay as far clear of the loud shouting men as he can. And he'd want to sort of quietly follow at a distance behind Malcolm and Degott. And when he got around to the tree that you said was on the other property...
So, no.
Go ahead.
So you have a wall that kind of comes around the building, okay? Yeah. So if the building were like this, so that the... Hold on, just watch the thing. Be like here and here.
Watch what thing?
The video. You don't have me on video, do you?
That's fine. I do. Hold on.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So basically, you would have like the house, right?
Mhm.
That's how the wall goes, and then inside the backyard property, on the backyard of this house, there's a tree.
Right.
Not on the other side of the wall. It's inside of the property. This property.
Okay. So I guess I'd want to look to see if the tree comes up against a window.
Sure does.
And that window's barred?
It does look like it from here, but your cat eyes allow you to see that it's not very... it looks like only a couple of boards were placed. It doesn't look like it was heavily barred like the ones on the lower.
So... Shadow would want to motion to... Are Malcolm and Degott still in range, or have they gone past?
They probably would be walking back. They would have made it to the end of the hedgerow and turned around and came back while you're basically analyzing that.
So if they're walking back towards me, I'd motion up and I'd say, I want to check this window.
That is to Degott and Malcolm.
Malcolm. So it seems like Dieter is having trouble with the Twitch stream.
Again, no problem. Something. No problem. He's having problems with the video in the bottom corner. I'll try and do less visual displays for... Okay, you're good.
I got it. Yeah,
do you see me?
Yep.
No, I don't see you.
I don't either. I see you. I have it on video and voice.
Click reset. Click reset.
Yeah, the reset button underneath video and voice.
I clicked reconnect and I'm getting nothing.
Okay, no worries. No worries. I'll do less video or visual presentation. It's fine. Let's move. So
I'm motioning to like Malcolm and Degott that I want to climb the tree and check the window. It doesn't seem like it's barred very tightly or boarded very tightly.
So that would be a comment from one character to two other characters.
Right.
Say it again. I'm trying to fix my video.
Sure. Malcolm, Jugaat, I think I see a way to get in. If I climb that tree, the window does not look tightly boarded up.
Ooh, wonderful.
So I'm going to try to climb that tree and test it out.
To get to the tree, you have to climb over the wall and then move through the backyard to the tree, then climb it.
Got my friend, help our young, our companion over the wall. It's rather tall. I put those muscles of yours to use.
I brace myself against the wall and make a basket in my hands to help him over.
Super.
Okay. Do me a favor and make a strength check or strength saving throw, Andy.
And you're keeping in mind that I have a climb of 20. I could
strength
climb.
Saving throw.
Okay.
Okay. So you manage to push yourself through the brambles and ivy that, as I mentioned, are coming up over the wall and are basically like razor wire as you're kind of pushing them through. You do take 2 points of damage, but you do manage to get through and onto the other side. Once there... You can see that you've kind of fallen into kind of bush, not very dense bush, kind of loose bush. Someone tell Joe he's got to go. I can't have too many people. You can see the tree, and also to your right, you can see that there's a lot of the. He was coming in to tell you. Oh wait, no, never mind. I got it. Never mind. So, anyways, to your right, there is a bunch of like old, dead kind of ivy and brambles, some stones in the courtyard, kind of close to the building, and with your eyes, you would be able to see that it looks like there's another kind of mound of dirt. About 45 feet away from you, like on the other side of the backyard, it looks like a poorly thrown together kind of grave.
Okay. So from where I'm at, what's the next step to get to that window?
So moving up the tree, you have a climb speed, so you hop up the tree, mm-hmm. and then there's a branch that kind of leads to the window.
Okay.
All right, go ahead and make an acrobatics check because it's less of a climb check, more of a kind of a waltz. Okay, you managed to make it across to the window. There you have it. What do you do next?
I'm going to check the window to see if I sense any possible traps.
Make an investigation check.
Awesome sauce.
Did he go from the window to the wall?
He went from the wall to the courtyard, or the backyard, from the backyard to the tree in the backyard, up the tree, straight to the window.
Sweet remix, bro.
Sweet,
What?
Sorry, keep going.
Were you making jokes? This is serious business. This is serious business.
Jokes for the live audience, man. Jokes for your live audience.
This is serious business.
Keep it light and entertaining.
We're playing D&D, okay? Serious business.
Serious business.
Serious. No, I don't care. Whatever. Okay, so you can kind of see into the window as you're investigating. It looks like the room inside is completely empty and covered with a heavy amount of dust. The shadow of the tree you're currently standing on is kind of shining in, or kind of like in the window. The moonlight is kind of coming in from behind you. It is foggy still, but it's still kind of a decent amount of light that's kind of blaring through. You can see into the room, is what I'm saying. But it doesn't seem like it's trapped or anything.
Okay, I'm going to try to remove the boards quietly.
Well, no, so there's the window first.
Oh, okay, okay, great, okay. I want to open the window.
Make a reflex saving throw.
What?
Or dexterity saving throw.
Nasty things are happening to you, sir.
All right. So the second you start to kind of fidget with the window and pop it open, you recognize your folly. You see a glyph that's bright red kind of emanate in the center of the window and burst out from the window into the tree. You dodge it well enough, so you take 5 points of fire damage.
Okay, I'm going home, guys.
And the tree is caught aflame. It's not like ignited full on, like whoosh up and up, but there's a bit of fire. If it's left to its own, it will kind of burn.
Okay.
This is the really dead tree?
Uh huh, in the backyard, yeah.
So I'm going to slide down that tree really quickly.
Okay.
And I am hurt pretty badly.
Okay. Do me a favor and make another dexterity saving throw for me. You wear a cloak, correct?
Yep.
Okay. As you kind of move out of the tree and kind of are like, you know, rushing down, you kind of pull your cloak along you, like in hopes of kind of dragging the flame out as well, and getting the flame off of yourself. And you manage to do just that. So you manage to stop the problem of the tree being a bright blazing beacon for the town guard to come check it out, and also a problem for you as you try to descend the tree. You get down just fine.
Now, I assume putting out the fire was still all of us standing around saw the bright flash of the glyph going off.
Dugot and Malcolm would. The others on the other side of the house would not. The house basically is blocking their line of sight to it.
Shadow would say, are there any healers here? I could really use some help.
I apologize.
Not a one.
I have an axe.
All right, guys, I'm going home then.
So as you kind of get down to the bottom of the tree, you hear a flapping of wings. And the strange owl lands on the eave above the window. He then hops down with a flutter and lands at the window that's just slightly pushed ajar by his flapping. And you kind of opened it a bit. And he makes his way inside of the house through the wooden boards.
No! You, no, Gavin!
You,
no, don't go in there.
Cardiff would have seen the owl fly over the house to the back side of the house.
Okay, then I'd start shuffling.
Heading that way.
Yep. I have an idea. I'm just going to go back to the front of the house or a window like that's not blocked by the large wall. And I have a crowbar as part of my criminal background. And I'm going to try and pry off some boards and see how that goes. Maybe let Chody try it because he has a higher strength. Depends on whether it's a strength test or a sleight of hand check.
So let's start with wall. Do you want the south wall, the west wall, the east wall, or the north wall? Or do you just want to go to the front door?
Hold on. I had to go let somebody in. Say that again. Was that to me?
Which wall do you want? South wall, west wall, east wall, or north wall? Because you're going to...
Oh.
Yeah.
The door is facing what direction?
The door... Like, the main door is facing north, but it's on the north wall. Yeah.
Door is on the north wall. They can't see you. I don't have a camera. Sorry. Elizabeth says hi.
Hey.
Hello.
Let's see. So we went east the first time, and the west is going to be about a mirror image of what we saw, right, with that different house on that side?
So, yes, but it won't have the stone wall that's on the side. It doesn't look like it has that. Basically, that stone wall on the right side of the house is like a garden area.
Yeah.
There is no garden area.
So, if I go around to the west side, is there no wall blocking my entrance to this house's property?
Correct.
Then, on the south side of the house, in what is, I guess, the backyard?
Mm-hmm.
Is there a back door or window that's been boarded up?
There's a back door and two windows. Basically, two bay.
Most easily accessible.
There are two.
Boards.
Sure. So there are two bay windows that look like they have like barricades that have been built into them. If you've ever played Fallout 4, like those little gun barricades that they build, they turn the bay windows into that. The door itself looks just like a mirror image of the front door. And it, too, is securely, like, sealed up. Looks like it was boarded up on both sides, from what you can see.
The door was boarded on both sides?
Yeah. And,
but the windows were not.
The windows looked like they were replaced. Like, the glass was shutted out, or, like, cracked out, and they basically built a barricade instead.
Got it. Did the front door look like it had been boarded from the inside and outside?
Just the inside. That one would probably, so far as to say, Besides the window that's up in the tree, would be the easiest one. The one that's up in the tree, the bird got in just fine.
Aramil, when the old man starts shuffling towards the burning tree or what was, Aramil's going to start slowly checking out the west side of the house since nobody went over there, right?
Sure. So the west side of the house, you'll see that there are a total of 3 windows, basically northmost, middle, and southmost. The northmost one would probably be to the window. If you enter in that window, it would go to the foyer, the same entryway as the door. If you go to the middle one, you're not sure. And the one at the south side is probably going to the same room that has those 2 bay windows.
And they all are similarly barred.
Correct. Everything on the ground level is heavily barricaded. The door on the back side is double barricaded.
John, you see Whisper?
Hold on.
It's a yay or a nay.
I don't see your Whisper. Oh, it's in, no.
20.
Yeah, I don't see it.
All right, I'll try again.
I'll start circling back around to the rest of the group.
Okay. You guys, in the back, you would see Cardiff approaching you. This would be mainly for Dugot, and because Malcolm's kind of looking over, checking out the backyard, and Dugot's still kind of probably their source of getting up there.
In this exchange, I'm going to pull my crowbar out of my sack and hand it to Dugot and say, try to get in somewhere, but do so quietly.
Cardiff looks at you guys as he kind of approaches. He's definitely bewildered and confused, looking around up at the building. And what does he say?
What are you? Did you see a bird by chance, sir?
Yes, of course. There was an owl, I believe, scurried in through the upper windows.
Oh, my damn bird. Who are you? I'm Cardiff.
Malcolm? I extend a hand.
He eagerly extends his hand and shakes it heartily.
I shake it heartily back.
Nice to meet you. Well,
awfully late for a man your years. What brings you out this time of night?
Well, there was an altercation with my bird and myself, and I can't sleep without knowing he's safe. He and I are good friends, and have been for some time. And well, you see, I must be going now. I have to fetch my friend. Yeah, if I just figure out how to get into that perch there.
So it's stroking his beard and
I raise the contemplate. I can help.
Really?
It's hard to hear you.
That better?
Nah. Cardiff, how exactly does one get into an altercation with a bird?
Well, you see him.
Just at that moment, you hear a and you see the bird looking out the window.
Oh, damn it, Cardiff!
Basically, he's just like this. He's like, and then he just.
I take it that's your bird.
Yes, Gavin.
Yeah.
I really go to one of the windows and start pulling off the boards.
Okay, so do you go up over the wall to get to a window, or do you go around to the front of the building, or do you go around to the opposite side of the building? My question is which window are we going into? So are you just going to the first one that you can get to?
The one that he...
Dude, I took all the damage for that. Go through that window.
Nobody else is as quick and light on their feet to get up the tree, though.
Yeah, I'm slow. But yeah, I'd go to the closest window just to get in there. I'm wanting to get in there as quick as possible.
So you'd go to the north side of the house, okay? And then once you kind of walk around, you kind of pass by the weird bramble door. And then you would see a window kind of behind some bushes. You kind of move over to it. You're now concealed in the bushes. And you'd have to kind of break out the glass. And then you'd kind of start, you know, motioning and moving at the boards and pushing them through. Go ahead and make me an athletics check so I can determine how, like, much time that takes. Okay. So you're in and through in about 10 minutes. No problem.
Okay. I motion to the rest of the group. We can get in this way.
It would have been 5 minutes if you were moving less quiet, but I assumed you were going stealthy. Is that correct?
He told me to be as quiet as possible, so yeah.
10 minutes. All right. All right, and then once you have the window open, then you're going to go back around and make sure everybody is aware the window is ready to be entered and go back around to it, right?
Yes.
Okay. Just as you put the last board down, wipe the sweat off your brow, and kind of go, all right, now I'm going to go tell my friends in your head, you hear this strange noise come from inside the house. It's just so loud. Clang, clang, clang.
My hand instinctively goes towards my axe.
Do we hear that noise from where we are?
No, just him. It's on his side of the house. As you kind of look in the window, I'm assuming, with your axe, you're kind of curious. What you're looking at inside this room with your vision looks to be like a kitchen. It must have been a kitchen. They're smooth, kind of, you know, wood that's kind of, laying out on the ground. Looks like it's kind of chipped and broken a bit. Looks like it might have had some sort of lacquer to it. Looks like there's old rusted cooking utensils just lying on the ground, discarded in the hearth of a cook fire or a fireplace. There are cupboards and cabinets that are kind of set in the walls, but all are left open, and the old and useless contents have been kind of set out. The counters aren't present. Looks like they kind of removed all of the furnishings. Someone did, anyways. But the contents of those counters have been set on the floor or kind of jostled about inside their cupboards. There appears to be a door to the north and a boarded up door to the west. So you'd presume that that door to the west leads into that garden space in between the wall and the building.
As long as I didn't see anything or anything catch my attention in there after that noise, I would still wait for everyone else.
Sure. And then you kind of look in and you would see that there's also a door on the east wall. That just looks like a normal regular door as well, just like the one on the north side. But that is pretty much where you think the sound came from. It had to have been on the other side of the door.
Okay, then I'll definitely keep an eye on that door.
Okay. How long do you wait?
Oh, I mean, I'm going to wait a few seconds, and as long as nothing moves or anything, yep. I'm going to move and get everyone else.
Nothing springs at you and tries to murder you.
Yeah, then I'm going to go get the others.
Okay.
Do God, my friend, have you had any luck?
We're in this way, sir.
Oh, wonderful. Cardiff, I don't suppose, I am up and down. Are you up for crawling in a window?
Well, if I had to, I suppose there's worse things.
Very good. And I give him a hearty slap on the back, and I follow the guy around. Chaff, where are you? What are you doing?
Circling back around you guys.
Yep.
Once we make it to the window, I'll help each person in the window.
Who's first?
If I'm back, I'll go first. Took him 5 minutes, so I'm assuming I got around the house.
10 minutes, but yeah.
Yeah, then house can't be that big. I'll go in first.
You would have seen like pretty much everything I explained to them if you walked around the house. Like you would have seen the windows that I mentioned on that side. The backyard it's walled by a stone wall. It has brambles up on top of the 12-foot high stone wall. There really isn't much to it on the outside. You cart Aramil into the house. And if you didn't get my description before, Shaft, it's basically, it looks like a kitchen that looks like a lot of the kind of furnishings that were present, like there were counters, but they're gone. The cupboards have been kind of left open. The floor looks like it's covered in kind of a lacquer, which, you know, you'd kind of want like that or tile or something in a kitchen because lots of spills, you know, not so good with wood. It looks like the lacquer's kind of chipped and broken, It looks like a kitchen. It looks like it was once a kitchen. So the only things of note in this room are there's a boarded up door on the west wall. There is a regular door on the on the west wall. Boarded up door on the east wall. and then there's a regular door on the south wall. And there's a fireplace kind of in the south corner in the interior of the house.
So just to clarify, the east wall is the boarded up one, and then the west and south are the ones that are not boarded?
West and south are not boarded, correct. Can you get me...
How difficult are the boards on the...
You didn't get...
East door look to get off.
Should we check for traps?
So you're going to check the west door, you said?
I'm just going to go kind of investigate it and just see how easily the boards would be to be removed.
Okay, perfect. And anything else of note? Anything else of note? The floor does look like it's a bit dirty as well. Like it's covered with a pretty fine layer of dust. It looks like it hasn't been traversed very in recent history. Anything else you want to do while you move over there?
No.
All right, who are you throwing in next?
I'll just get in position, and whoever steps up first, I'll also let them know that a noise came from that door.
Okay. So...
Noise came from what door?
He points towards the west door.
Why didn't you tell me that ahead of time?
You hear a loud, oh, come from that door now.
Oh, this is getting fascinating. I brush myself off and step up to Dugat and kind of shake my booty a little bit and start climbing up, like pushing on the top of his head to like lift myself up and get up over and into the window. I'm making it comically difficult on purpose.
Pop right in. Like on your approach up, you kind of like accidentally poke him in the back or rear end with your horn and then right in.
All right, I look around with my sweet-ass dark vision. What am I seeing, man?
Same thing.
All right.
Everybody in this group has dark vision except for Cardiff.
I think this house might actually be haunted.
I ready my sword and shield.
Okay. And there's, like I said, there's a door on the west wall. There's a door on the south wall. There's a fireplace in the back corner. Oh, sorry. That fireplace is lit. I apologize. That fireplace is lit.
Oh, that's...
That is an
game changer.
That is an important factor.
Is it a natural looking fire?
Yeah, looks like a it looks like it's in a smoldering stage, but yeah, it does look like it's a natural looking fire.
But there's no footsteps anywhere around at all. Just unsettled dust.
Are you looking for footprints? That sounds like you are. So yes.
Yeah, I would like to
make a survival check.
When I notice the fire smoldering, I'm going to cast Armor of Agathys on myself with my one spell slot.
Okay.
So I have 5 temporary hit points, and anything that hits me while I still have some of those points takes 5 damage.
I know how it works. If you want to just click the macro for everybody else, do you have it?
I don't have a macro for
That's
it.
That's cool.
Hold on. I'll get you set up.
Where do I find those macros?
So, Shuttle will go in last.
Okay. What you'll do is when you bring your character sheet up, you go to your spell section and you see how it says first level. You'll hit add. It'll bring up a new one. Click on the I in the top right corner. Type the name of the spell.
Wait, nope. I don't see character sheet. Where do I see spells on here?
You'll see in a second. Oh, Armor of Agathys is apparently not one that's in the player's handbook. Wow, that's stupid.
I assume it's elemental evil. Sword Coast Adventurer's Guide.
Oh, no. Armor of Agathys is in the player's handbook. It's just not one that they have in the SRD.
Those bastards.
Yeah, well, anyways, do you see where it shows Armor of Agathys?
No, I don't know where I'm supposed to be looking.
Kind of the middle of your page, yeah.
Yes.
You'll basically need to fill that out. We'll get to it in a bit. But anyways, so next up would be Cardiff, because Tabaxi said he's last.
So what happened with the footprints?
Thank you. You see that it looks like there was a number of individuals that trafficked this room about a month and a half ago. They just trafficked through this place. You're presuming that all of the kind of jostling of things is probably there a result of those people.
But the fire, obviously not.
Correct.
Do the footprints lead anywhere?
No. So basically in and out of the house, all over the house. It looks like whoever was responsible for those footprints were the ones responsible for boarding up the house.
Can I tell which direction the footprints, which door
all
they went to?
All over the house. For one more time.
All right.
All right. Next is... Okay, so Cardiff, he kind of hauls you into the house if you're going.
Yeah, definitely.
All right. You see there's just like a little bit of light because of the fire.
Well, Cardiff would take a moment and kind of brush off his garb and kind of reposition all of his clothing underneath of him. And the first thing he would do is cast light on the tip of his staff.
Okay.
And then I would assume I would see what you were describing previously.
Yeah, everything that I've explained. It's the room isn't very big. It's only by like 20 by. Well, my brain just did a fart. It's only like 25, 30 feet by 20 feet.
Okay. In addition to that, he would kind of reach into his robe and pull out a book.
Well then, seems like it started here.
And he just starts reading his book. I'm going to start casting Detect Magic as a ritual. If there's enough time to permit it, then there's enough time to permit it. If not, then we'll just move on. Does that make sense?
No,
that's what he's going to be focusing on.
He's basically chanting to himself, standing kind of in a corner of the room. Got it.
Yep.
The Malcolm chucks the... Dugot chucks the tabaxi in.
By the singed fur... And I would want to check out one of the, you said there are doors on the north and the south side?
No. So the south and the west side.
Okay. I'd want to check. Let's check the south door for traps.
Okay. Go ahead and make another investigation check for me.
It worked really well last time.
It did. The door does not appear to have any traps. Another thing about the door is it doesn't appear to have any kind of locking mechanism. It seems to be sitting in its frame. And could easily be pushed either way.
Okay. I will note that to the others.
I hop in the window whenever I get a chance and pull my axe off right away.
Okay. You've got your axe in hand. You can see everything that everybody else has seen. What do you do, Chody?
I head towards that door where I heard the sound, to the west.
All right. So do you open the door and move through it, or you just stand in front of it, ready? Which one are you doing, Jody?
I stand in front of the door and motion to the others that this is the way the sound was, this is the way we need to go.
Okay. And then?
Once everyone's ready, I will... You said it looks like the door can push it either way?
No, different door.
That's the south door.
Oh, sorry. Then, I'm going to slowly open the door.
Okay. So, everybody, this is what's happening. He hops in. He kind of looks at you guys and kind of, you know, motions with his hand at the door that he leads up to, and then starts to move his hand towards the door as if he's going to open it. So, just very quickly, if you are following up with him, I'm going to say your name and just say yes or no. So, Dieter?
Yes.
Cardiff?
You know what I'm doing.
Staying in the room, then?
Well, I mean, if he's going to start moving along, then I'll go with him. But
you'll still be chanting to yourself.
Currently, what I'm doing is I'm focused on this. So if there's any type of reactions,
got it.
I'll be ill-prepared.
Yep. Aramil.
No, not at first.
You're not going with him? Okay, and Tabaxi Man, Shadow?
I'm not yet. No, I'm just going to wait and see what happens.
All right, so the door is opened, and you guys move into the next room. What you see on the other side... appears to be the main entrance hall. It looks like it was a once grand foyer. It is devoid of furniture and covered in a thick layer of dust. Up above you, you can see cracked stained glass windows looming above the hall and the stairs that lead up to the gallery above. Those stained glass windows are not external windows. So basically you have like the landing above, and set in that landing are those windows, if that makes any sense. And there are two doors in this chamber that you can see that are opposite of the main door. So you have the main door, which is a kind of like a double door with like a French window kind of deal, but it's boarded up. It's all sorts of boarded up. But there's the stairs to your left, and then around the stairs kind of on that north or south wall are a pair of double doors.
I look to Cardiff and say, your bird should be upstairs.
Did you hear him?
No, from where he flew in the window. We saw him fly in the window.
Kevin!
He closes his book quickly. You hear a loud thud, and he puts it back in his robe.
Okay. Shadow, you can see that everybody's kind of moving through the door.
Yep, so he'll follow.
Okay. All right. So since you're in the lead, Dugat, you see those two doors, as mentioned. It looks like there's one on the left, one on the right. And just as you're kind of looking at the doors, kind of deciding, you can see the let me start that sentence over. You hear a sound come from the door on your left, the left door. It sounds like something kind of moving around.
I point my axe and kind of motion that way of where it is.
So how loud could I hear this?
Yeah, everybody can hear the sound. So basically what it sounds like is something's kind of rustling through or like kind of moving out of a chair or something, like some furniture is being displaced.
So it sounds like, is it kind of a large sound? Like, is it?
Have you ever like slid a chair on wood?
Yeah.
Sounds like that. Yeah, like
cat. Definitely not Gavin. Okay.
Yeah. Super. Well, no, he's a pretty decent sized owl. He could probably move a chair.
Okay.
Kevin! Kevin!
Okay. So, yeah. Tell me what you're doing.
I move towards the door.
All right. And I'm assuming you then open the door.
What way does it open?
It looks like it opens inward.
I'll go to the other side of the door with my swords drawn.
Cardiff would then position himself kind of sheepishly behind Dugant. I assume he's the biggest one, right?
Yeah, sure is.
Put his hand on his back and try and peer around side of him, hand to his mouth, quietly whispering,
"Get over here, boy! Now!"
And Malcolm, I'm assuming you're moving in kind, getting into the group as well.
Yeah, of course. Okay.
And I'm assuming that you're falling in as well, Shadow, right? Make me a perception check as you move out of the kitchen into the foyer. All right. As you step out of the door, you hear a loud thud from the kitchen, but it's like loud to you, but you realize that it's not very loud, if you get my meaning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. So I'm going to motion to the others that and say there's a noise back there, pointing back to the kitchen area.
I say in a low voice, there's one in here as well.
I'll go back to the kitchen door and peer inside.
Yeah, I'd like to do that as well. I'll just sort of just peek into the doorway and see what we see.
All right. Go ahead and both of you make... are you just looking, like just taking a peek, or are you actually searching?
I'm just taking a peek from around the outside of the door.
Perception check.
So whatever I could see from that area.
Perception check. Okay. So you don't see anything, Shadow. And Aramel, you don't see anything either. But your keen elvish ears pick up the sound of foot on stone. But there doesn't appear to be any stone present.
From any particular direction?
You aren't 100% sure. But you're pretty certain that it's somewhere in the floor.
Yeah.
Definitely something off about this house.
Shadow will look at Aramil and say, it's ghosts.
I don't believe in ghosts. But there's something going on here.
And so we'll go back and follow the others.
Okay. All
Does
right.
Cardiff know anything in particular about ghosts?
Are you thinking about ghosts while you're doing your ritual?
No, I'm not. I close my book once they started moving. Do I have to stay in one spot to do a ritual?
Or not can really. You do a ritual on the move? You can kind of wander around, but you
then I'll focus on the ritual then, definitely.
Okay, so you're about to shut your book and think about ghosts, and you go, and you start.
Well, I didn't know what I could do.
It's fine.
To be honest.
Yeah, you can yeah, rituals take 10 minutes of focus on the ritual. You've only kind of moved around a little bit. You haven't really focused on other stuff besides maybe okay. yelling at Gavin. That's fine.
I'll continue focusing on the detect magic ritual.
Okay. Once everybody gets into position, I assume Dugat is opening this door.
Yeah, I'm going to push it open with my axe.
All right. And as you do so, it makes a loud creaking sound. Of course, you would see that just on the opposite side of this door, there appears to be a room that's lined with the walls kind of set with empty shelves. There's an old desk that sits against the south wall, and all but one of its drawers are pulled open. The wall on the east hosts an empty a fireplace with a soot and ash covered hearth. And it looks like just kind of a pile of like simmering, burning wood. It's not like strong flame, just a little bit of a flame.
I'm going to move into the room and look around.
Anything that I've mentioned that specifically you're focusing on?
Honestly, the biggest thing in the room, which is probably the hearth, so I'm probably going to look at it.
Okay, make a survival check. And who moves into the room next? I believe Aramil was next in line, yeah?
I went back to the kitchen, but I'm happy to go second.
Oh, okay. So then, yeah, you would be back that way. You're right. So let's go with Malcolm. What do you do once Dugat goes in?
I'm going to follow behind him and scan the room, looking okay. for threats and treasure.
There's a desk. The desk drawers are all pulled open except for one desk drawer.
I approach the desk and sit down.
Okay. As you sit in the chair breaks. Make a dexterity saving throw.
You can see the leg has been partially sawn off.
At least it didn't turn you to stone like DJ games.
Okay. So you manage to catch yourself aright, and you don't fall flat on your tush. But when you do, it does snap, and you kind of look back at the chair. You do notice that the back legs look like they were intentionally made to fail.
That bastard.
Gnome is playing tricks on us from the grave.
I look to the lock or the one drawer on the desk that is closed. Is there a visible lock on it?
So the closed drawer of the desk has a silver keyhole set in it.
I jiggle the drawer to see if it opens.
Make a dexterity saving throw. And Dugat, do
that. Check for likewise. Traps.
Ooh.
I can't check for traps. I'm not a thief.
Yeah, but that's right. I'm here.
The relevant skills.
All right. So that's a failure. And Chody, you need to make a dexterity saving throw. Success. Chody, take 5. Dieter, take 10. As the entirety of the desk bursts in flame after a single red glyph appears above it and bursts out from it, detonating the entire room with flames.
Wow.
Yeah. Looks like the contents of the desk are destroyed.
Kitchen's looking pretty safe now.
Confused.
What in the hell?
I'm confused. Why? All of these numbers are appearing twice because it's rolling as if he had advantage.
Yeah, you pick the first one.
So you always go with the first one. It basically to save me the time of saying you clicking buttons and changing advantage to disadvantage in your character sheet.
Yeah.
I set it to roll 2. We go with the first one. If I said you have disadvantage, we go with the lowest one. If I say we rolled with advantage, you go with the highest one.
It's just always painful when you see that second roll is a crit.
Yeah. The emotional turmoil is too much for me, I think.
I want the second roll.
How about the emotional turmoil of being at 1 hit point?
Yeah, I'm at 5 hit points, 6 hit points.
Oh, Agathys, right. Uh-huh. Right.
So the desk takes 5 fire damage, but whatever. Or 5 prop.
So you... Hold on. Hmm.
So there's like a...
No. No.
Harry Potter.
Wait. Because this is interesting. Roll a percentile die. If you get 50 or less, then something interesting will happen. Roll percentile. Haha. So the fire bursts out into the arm of Agathys, and the spell basically retorts with ice coldness, and like a fire extinguisher, hits the desk full frontal with its icy burst and saves the contents of the desk.
Does it save my hit as well?
No. It doesn't. It doesn't stop the damage. You still get full blasted. No. You still take the
just
damage.
The damage to the desk.
The desk is saved.
The important part.
Do we know enough about glyphs to know if that thing will go off every time we try to get into the desk, or is that a one-use thing?
Make an arcana check.
Always ask the wizard.
Ask the creepy old man with a book.
Hey, creepy old man with a book. Tell me. Carter, come here.
What happened?
I noticed.
There's been a magical disturbance. I may have set off some sort of glyph warding.
I noticed.
I don't suppose you know if that nonsense is liable to happen again.
Make an arcana check.
You know, I don't know.
Actually,
they're almost dead and you're laughing.
So based off of the description, you can't identify what the spell was, but you tell him that the most likely culprit, because you are pretty arcanely sound, and a 10 okay. is still an average roll, you would say, oh, it's probably a fire trap or a glyph, and all of those dispel after they've been once used.
I say that as I scooch further from the room.
Wonderful. You got, bring that crowbar over here and see if you can't get this drawer open.
I go over and
I step very far away.
Okay, so are you opening the drawer just to open the drawer, or are you trying to do so without a lot of force and just like get it open soundly?
I'm trying to get open soundly without breaking if there's...
Okay.
Because I know there's probably something in it, so...
Just make a dexterity check. Just a raw dexterity check. Okay. So you force the door, you do it a little heavily, and the drawer kind of slides out and like into your arms. And you manage to catch it, but it looks like a single glass vial flies out of the drawer and hits the ground and shatters, its red contents spilling out all over the floor. It looks like a watered down blood, really. And it just stains the ground.
Menstruation.
You lick at it, but it doesn't really do anything for you.
Lick it.
Boo.
Inside there are two sheets of paper, and there is one other vial.
I move over to investigate the contents of the drawer that you got has opened, and I curse a little at the vial that's broken on the ground. And I will inspect the papers, and if I can read them, I will, and if not, I will begin passing them around the room to find someone who can.
One paper looks like it has arcane gibberish on it. The other paper looks like it has a very short missive that reads... I'll just go ahead and... I'll just read it. It reads, the gem that you are working on for me, Lord Dorshak Crane... was wonderful and has served my every purpose. I send you back I never wrote this letter out. it shows that I'm unprepared in the one spot that comes up. It says, I've returned your fee as per our arrangement. Signed, the Flesh Thief.
Ooh, creepy.
Interesting.
But the scroll, Dan, I'm assuming is being passed the scroll.
I'll pass it to Dan Young since Dan, he's the arcane gibberish master.
Go ahead and make a arcana check.
Hopefully I roll better than a...
DC's 11.
That's better.
You immediately recognize the spell as Identify.
Were there any other doors on this floor?
I passed the scroll back.
There was one more door out the other way. Yep.
Back to Malcolm and explain the purpose.
You're some sort of wizard, right? Do you know this spell already?
A wizard? I'm a chronomancer, good sir. A wizard? I don't have the time to... Time? Time?
Do you know this spell or not, you crazy old bat?
No. I can't say I do.
Can you transfer it into your little spell book there, your book of rituals? Perhaps just paste it in with a piece of tape or something? I don't know. Here.
That's true. Okay. All right.
He'll roll it up and put it in his robe there.
All right. So Aramil and Shadow, we haven't talked to you in a while. Aramil, you're kind of towards the back. Everybody's kind of moving in. It sounds like a lot of commotion's been happening. Explosions, falling chairs, etc. Laughing, yelling. Laughing, yelling wizards. And then, just out of nowhere, the two of you hear a come from upstairs. You're not exactly sure. And then you hear a flutter, flutter, flutter. What do you want to do, Chef? What do you want to do?
I'm going to head to the... I mean, I've seen the bird, so I assume it's the bird.
Head to the other door is where you're going. Okay, so that door opens up. Are you checking it for traps? Or?
Yeah, I was going to place my ear against the door and see if I could hear anything inside.
Okay. Dead silence.
You want Thief to check it for traps?
It doesn't seem to be trapped. I open the door.
Shadow stands back.
It opens into a small hallway. The wall appears to have some brass hooks on it. Then there's a window on the opposite wall that leads out. This is the middle window, you presume, on the wall that you checked out, the outside wall you checked out. And then looks like it's 10 feet of hallway and another door.
Yeah, no. You should probably check that hallway for traps, though, yes.
Someone who's a bit more competent at it should go first, I think.
So if he calls for Shadow to do that, I'll check the traps.
Sorry, in character.
Investigation on the door isn't necessary because there aren't any traps on the door. And you open that door then, the final door? In the hallway? Yep. So,
we were investigating the hallway for traps.
Nothing needed trap. There was nothing. That's why I said don't roll anything.
Okay.
Yep. So you open up that door on the far side, and you would see a long hall of a room. It might have once served as a room to entertain guests or for hosting dinner parties. The floor is just bare boards, rotted and dark, with moisture in the south west corner. The windows are covered with tattered, faded drapes. It looks like they are all boarded up, specifically those bay windows. The floor near those windows, specifically that rotted-looking floor, it's making a very strange clicking noise.
The floor is making the clicking noise.
Something about the floor, like not the floor itself, possibly something under the floor, is making a strange clicking noise. It sounds like... but it's not very loud. It's like just a gentle thrush of like clicking and clacking.
I haven't heard any more of the walking on stone noise, right?
No.
Can I investigate the floors to see if they're hollow or see if there's a...
Well,
careful.
Real quick, so the barbarian, you're going to just move past everybody and then check the sound, is that right?
No, I just said from listening, would nature be able to...
So they're in a 10-foot long hallway that's 5 feet wide, and they're basically inside of that hallway. So the two of them are taking up the whole hallway. The only way you're going to go and check that sound is if you move past everybody into the room itself.
I'll wait then.
Can I start like banging my, not banging, but like prodding my staff onto the floor to see if it creaks, like there's a basement or there's something underneath the floors or hollow.
Sure. Yeah, it does sound like there's, you know, some distance between the floor that you're pounding on and the foundation below. So there might
be. So it's not a solid thud.
Yeah, so there might be kind of like a crawl space underneath or something to that effect.
Hmm. There might be a compartment under these floors. In my younger days, I might break my back to lift it, but I fear I'm not quite in the condition right now. What if you young lads care to maybe...
Just as you're about to ask the questions about the floors, you feel two claws land on your shoulder, and you see two bright owl eyes looking at your face.
As it Gavin!
Flutters from down or from upstairs to you.
Oh, my boy. I apologize. I might have lied. I don't have a role at this time, but I promise. I promise, my boy. I won't. I'll share next time. I swear.
He looks at you with widened eyes. And as you admit that you don't have any rolls, he flutters off of your shoulder and flies up into the
no!
the landing upstairs.
Cardiff starts crying, ultimately remiss that he has lost his bird yet again.
Aramil's going to start slowly backing away from the room and head towards the stairs.
You hear a whisper, Dan, just as Aramil starts to move up the steps. And Aramil, you can hear it too. And it says... If you want your bird back, leave this place.
What? I don't give a shit about the bird.
Is he, you're just going to walk up the stairs? I mean, fuck that bird.
Obviously, Spooked Aramil is going to slowly go up the stairs and kind of, I'm assuming, is there any type of banister or anything that I can kind of peek over to just survey the area without going all the way up the stairs?
Sure. So let me explain like what you're kind of walking up to. So like the stairs go straight up, right? And basically above the stairs, there's kind of like a landing, but the landing's kind of like buttressed off with like a railing, and set inside of like some of those railing points, kind of set up to the wall, are little alcoves or portals that are holding broken stained glass windows. So as you kind of look up, you can see the landing like just fine. It doesn't appear like there's anything up there, but there are those broken bits of stained glass windows. If someone were, or if something were hiding up there, like it definitely could hide from your perception.
I'm going to start slowly walking up the stairs.
Okay. And it looks like the bird has kind of found its post up on the railing farthest from the steps. As you kind of make your way to the top of the steps, I need you to make me a... Wisdom saving throw.
You got this.
All right.
Yeah.
Yes, he does.
You hear whispers specifically aimed at you. We're coming for you. We're coming for you. We know where you are. We know where you live. We know where you sleep. But they don't seem to affect you as much as you assume they would probably affect a lesser man. But you do take 3 points of damage, psychic damage. From those whispers.
All right, I don't know how to change that, but
if you select your token, oh, you guys can't see your token. I've got you. Don't worry about it. I dealt the damage to you.
Okay.
You double dealt the damage to you. Okay, got it.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Figured it out too late.
All right, do you continue up the steps or do you stop?
Since I seem pretty confident, I'm going to continue up the steps.
Make a perception check. Okay. You just catch a glance of a gnome. Looks like he's... kind of on the opposite side of the railing from you, and it looks like he is kind of wiggling his fingers. It looks like he's just having finished casting a spell. I'm gonna move you into a battle board, Chef, so your view should change.
And you said I saw a person that wiggled his finger.
a gnome.
Okay.
Hate gnomes.
So do you see the gnome?
Yes.
And do you see the bird?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. All right. So make go ahead and roll initiative for me, because I'm assuming you're going to attempt to kind of, you know, catch him, right?
Catch him?
The gnome.
Is there, like, run after him?
Like, are you just going to look at him? Like, what's your plan? He just cast a spell
Shaft
at you.
Didn't consider this at all.
No, I didn't. So,
get him, Shaft.
But, and, sorry, so the initial plan was to
10,
retrieve him?
9, 8, 7, 6.
Yeah, I'll roll initiative.
Yeah. If you can't obviously react to someone having just cast a spell at you, then I don't know. I mean, if your character's going to think that much about it, then I'm not going to let you roll.
No, that's fine.
Select
I don't know how to roll.
Select your token, go to your character sheet, click on the word initiative or the bonus. It should do it. There you go. All right. Your dexterity is higher than his, so you will go first. So like I said, you can see the gnome. It's dark in here, obviously. And you can see the owl. And, yep, from his position, it looks like he has a little bit of cover from the railing. But you should be able to get a good shot at him if you were to take one, or you can try and move around the railing to catch to him. Or do whatever you want, actually. I don't care.
I currently have my swords drawn, so I don't. I can drop them and grab my bow and still fire.
So, yeah, if you want to sheath or drop them as a free action and draw the bow as a part of the attack action, that's fine.
Okay, I'll do that.
It'll take you an action to pick your swords back up, though. Okay. That will hit, dead on the nose. You hit him clear in the shoulder, pretty solid hit, and he looks like he's, like, visually shocked and quite scared. In response, he will move to here, open the door, shut the door, lock the door, and continue moving. His action was locking the door. All right. So at that point, I'm going to go ahead and cycle back to all the people downstairs. During that turn, you were hearing activity. You heard strange whispers. Then you heard an arrow get loosed, a bit of a grunt from the gnome as he was hit by it, and then slamming doors. Two, to be exact.
I rush upstairs.
Yeah, if I heard that arrow go, I would rush.
If you are intending to go for Broke and try and get to the fight, then I just need you to roll initiative.
There's an initiative button. I don't know where it is, so I made a macro.
It's on your character sheet, and it's right there in the center. Hold on.
Right, like, I see my plus two initiative bonus. I just don't know how to make a macro out of it.
Up in the top there, does it show the pencil as yellow or gray?
Yellow.
Click the pencil.
Yep.
Now click the initiative, the word initiative, while your token is selected. Oh, wait, you can't select your token.
I can't see a token.
Hold on. Let me go ahead and get you. Let me get you.
Get me, John. You got me.
All right. So you can see your tokens now?
I can't see anything.
Scroll down.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, that's me.
So select your token. Yeah. Click the initiative button.
There's no initiative button on my token.
The word initiative. Click initiative.
On your character sheet, buddy.
Oh, well, that's not my token.
It's not a button, I guess.
Is there a way to create a macro out of this? I don't have to.
It's automatic. It's automatically a macro. It's set there like that.
Where?
Well, not like
under macros?
No, it's not under macros. No, it's right on your character sheet.
So I have to open my character sheet and click initiative every time.
Or you?
Yeah.
Have it in a different window or something?
Yeah. You can expand your character sheet out of that window by pressing the little like double square box in the top left. Or if you don't want to like go into your journal each time, if you double click the name at the top of your character sheet, it'll minimize it within the window and gray it out so it's not blocking any view. And then you can just double click on the name again and bring it back up.
I'll figure it out.
I believe in you. I've always had.
Just to clarify, though, wasn't the mission to find him and loot his house?
Looting?
Or not the mission.
Looting? I'm here to get my bird.
All right, so Malcolm, you are moving up the stairs, and then you're going to the next floor. Okay, hold on a second. 20 and straight up to the top, then. Copy. Delete. You'll be able to make it to the top of the stairs with one single movement, and I'll move you into it. You should be able to see yourself at the top of the stairs now.
I do.
Okay. You can see the owl and the sound of the door. It's coming from over Chonderways. Chonderways.
What sound is coming from over there?
The sound of the door slamming came from over there.
Is there a way for me to move? My...
Should be able to. But you've already moved. So, if you dash, you can.
So it looks like those are more stairs?
What? Where?
You said I heard a door open.
You just ran up those stairs and then around the stairs to the other side.
Got it. It looked like you were just pointing downstairs. Like, I just came from there. I'm confused.
Sorry.
It took me 30 feet to get to the top of the stairs?
Yeah. The place that you're in is exactly 30 feet.
I guess... And I don't see any living creatures in this hallway.
The bird and Aramil.
I'll dash to get my movement back and use it to move down this hallway, to move around toward the sound of the door.
You can get to this square here.
Yep. Boop.
All right. Tabaxi.
Yeah, Tabaxi will... He's not going to run headlong into anything, but he will go up the stairs. So do I just move it myself, or how do you want me to do that?
Tell me how much movement it takes you to get to the top of the stairs.
From where I was?
Correct.
Okay, so hold on. I think I was right there, right? So it's 5. So this is the top. This is the foot of the stairs.
Top of the stairs.
This is the top. Okay, so that's that. 5, 10, 15, like 20.
So that'd be the top of the stairs. Yeah. So you have 10 feet of movement left.
Yep.
So similar to the tiefling, you'd be able to get to that.
I don't see anything at the moment.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, there we go.
Oh.
Okay.
Any actions?
This place is trapped like crazy, so I'm just going to search around as much as I could, like visually scan for anything that could be wrong. Walls, floors, you know, everything.
Okay, so make a perception check. 5. You recognize that those stained glass windows are really pretty.
That's great.
All right, Chody. Awesome.
Won't let me go up anymore.
No, yeah, so just go to the top of the stairs and tell me how much movement you have left.
Oh, I have, that is at 25 right there. I have 5 more for normal movement, and I'm going to go as far as I can.
Okay.
I'm dashing, I'm wanting to get to fight.
So, I'll just go ahead and place you where you'll end up, because you're running towards the sound.
Sounds good. I'm trying to ask where ghosts are. Want to kill me some ghosts. Again.
Okie dokie. Goes down to Aramil again. All these people are rushing past you.
I'll pick up my swords, draw them again, put the bow back up.
That's it. As an action. So you can move. Yep.
So the door is in front of Dugat that he ran into?
That's about 5 feet in front of Dugat. Yeah, it's right here.
Trying to move right behind him, but...
You got to move 35 feet, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. So you can move here instead.
That'll be fine. Do I move my guy, though?
You should be able to.
Click and drag?
Pick him up, yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't letting me. But yeah, right there.
Okay. And then it would go to Stuff Happens.
Cardiff, ever?
You guys hear another loud thud of a door. Andy, sounds like it's coming from your south side.
So, here?
Yeah, and then it would go to Cardiff.
Okay.
You hear a sound coming from the that strange room, the room that was this way that everybody heard the clicking sound coming from.
I heard it.
No, everybody else heard the clicking sound, and you also hear a sound coming from the kitchen. Going up the stairs.
Yeah, go up the stairs.
Yep, this is 15 feet here. Left, got it.
Gavin, please! My friend, does anyone have a parcel of food or
as you some bread? Come up the stairs and pass by the tabaxi, the bird lifts off of the railing and flies over to you and lands on your shoulder. Kind of crouches down low against your cloak and backpack.
Can I discern anything by his demeanor? Does he feel threatened?
He's scared?
Okay. I'll tuck him under my robe and protect him. And you notice a big change in Cardiff's demeanor. He looks really focused and... Yeah. Then move here. He's going to ready a spell if anything threatens him or Gavin or his new acquaintances.
Got it.
And can I have control of Gavin, please?
No.
Oh, yeah, of course. Well, could you keep him in my room?
Sure will. I'm just trying to figure something else out.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Okay, Malcolm Cricklewood. He said he was away for a second, but then he said he's back, so he's back. For fuck's sake.
What?
You going back downstairs?
No, I'm trying to add, a token. Talking, and it's
being Cardiff.
I've been moved.
What is this token that I see 5 feet away from me?
Aramel?
Who's that?
It's a me.
John Chat?
No. Not that one. The one two spaces away.
If it has a blue ring around it, it's an ally.
Probably do got.
Got it. So, like, I feel like it's very strange. Is there some sort of wall here in front of me that's preventing me from seeing further this direction?
Yeah, so the black portions are the stained glass that's kind of blocking your sight. It's not really visible through. The portions that don't have, like, blocking, like, seeing through... That's just the railing, so you can see through that.
I am going to begin moving around the corner.
Two doors.
What is that? What is that in front of two doors? Yep. Any glyphs written on them that are visible?
None that are visible. If you want to spend your action investigating, you can.
No, I want to spend my action opening the door.
Well, actions are... You can open a door without an action. It's fine.
I open the door.
All right. Inside you see the following. Upon entering the small bedroom, you see a stark contrast in this room from the many other rooms you've seen so far. This room is crammed full of wrecked furniture, bags of food goods, materials, books, bedrolls, just heaps and heaps of trash and stuff. Dozens of stacks of old gazettes and handouts are stacked about the trash as well. A rough horsehair kind of looking sleeping bag is rolled like kind of up near the fireplace, which is in the east wall.
Can I try to open? You said there are two doors, which I presume means they go two separate rooms because there's a big wall here. So can I open that other door from where I am, or do I need to move 5 feet in front of it?
You move 5 feet in front of it and then open it. Yeah, sure.
Boom.
It opens to a hallway that leads to another door.
So that was 5, 10. Wait, where was I? There. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Open the door.
All right. And this one. You would see following. A room that is completely empty and covered with heavy amounts of dust. A bay window is set in the north wall. It too is barred up, but it's less barred than the ones downstairs, so you can kind of see out the window and see the river.
Was this where the bird looked out at us from?
No, this is not that one. By the size of this room, though, you would consider it probably a master bedroom.
Completely empty?
Completely empty.
Any obvious tracks in the dust?
Make a survival check.
I mean, I'm not getting on the ground rolling around looking for them.
You're just kind of looking for tracks specifically and seeing where they lead. I get you. Not really.
Was that my action?
No, that was a freebie.
Did he have his pluses to his survival? Because he just rolled a d20.
I don't have any pluses to
know.
Okay, just check. Sorry, buddy.
It's okay. I'm an arcane guy, and my wisdom is 10. What are you going to do? I will use the dash action.
Okay, move some more.
What is that thing that I see?
It's a fireplace. Fire's smoldering, and it does have a mantle, and set on top of the mantle is a dagger.
If I'm standing here, is that in front of the fireplace or on the fire?
That's fine. Front of the fireplace.
Um, Is there this just a wall over here? There's no other doors leading out of this room?
Doesn't appear to be.
Okay. Banana phone. Okay.
Let's go ahead and say, unless you're picking up the dagger or doing something relative to
your... Pick up the dagger.
All right, you have a dagger. And then it'll go to Shadow. So as mentioned, the door to your south, there sounded like there was a noise that came from it.
Right. So I'm not going to worry about that noise. There's noises everywhere. I'm just going to follow my companions.
There are noises everywhere.
True. Right there is my movement. I think they're just screwing with us.
I think the gnome has a bunch of hidden passages, and he is still alive and faking the haunting for some reason. Maybe because some flesh weaver is trying to get this crystal. I don't know.
Are you saying that out loud? Can I hear him? No, he's in the other room.
Do you have an action that you want to take, Andy, or no?
Could I just look around for any obvious traps or problems?
Sure. No need to roll. Nothing like that. You're actively perceiving. That's fine.
Yep.
Chody, following your friend?
Yep.
All right, go ahead and move south. And move your speed and tell me what you do once you get into the room. And I'll go ahead and start with Aramil, because I don't think you're going to... I mean...
Does the dash action give me my... Okay, never mind.
Dash just doubles your movement speed is what it does.
Yeah, I got it. I'm trying to figure out. It's just the way movement is spent in this edition.
Yeah.
So the only thing in this room is the fireplace, right?
The fireplace, correct.
Is there a fire going in it?
Oh, a light one, yeah. Just like the ones before. Do you want to roll a free survival check just to kind of go for... something you might have missed before. Just make a survival check. Yeah, you're really, really bad at that. Okay, cool. You're kind of looking around and just absolutely confused. All right. Aramil.
I'm going to open this door.
Okay. Upon opening this door, you would see a room that is completely empty and covered with a heavy amount of dust. The shadow... this is the wrong room. Let me try that again. Sorry. Let me repeat. This room is an old storage room. It looks like it was for linens and drapery. There are, even though they're not pictured at current, crates that appear to be filled with moldering bed linens, and the smell of the room is kind of earthy and musky.
This is not the dust. There's not a lot of dust.
There's a lot of dust. There's a lot of dust.
Okay. I'm done. I'll actually draw my bow as my action. Put my swords away. Did my character hear the sound from this other door? Or was that just Andy?
Just Andy.
Is there a solid snake underneath that box? It's just fucking moving around.
Oh no, I was putting crates in there because I didn't in the first place.
I know.
Okay.
It's great though.
Tabaxi, elf, and wizard. The door that was south of the Catman opens up, and you see a gnome. Which, Aramil, you recognize immediately as the gnome.
Ready to action.
You ready in action to do what?
To attack anything that poses a threat to me or my allies. If he's hostile in any way.
Yeah, I'll out. I'll watch the stream back, though, because I don't remember you saying it. I don't remember how you said it. But it's okay. It doesn't matter. Go with it. Shoot.
Okay.
Forget arguing the rules. Shoot me.
So could you finish that sentence he recognized as...
So Aramil recognized him as the one he shot a minute ago. Yeah.
Okay.
Your bolt goes wide, real wide, and hits the wall. And the gnome looks at you like, ah! And in response, he is going to do two things. First things first, he is going to cast a spell at you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be... Sorry. Hold on here. It's gonna be... This is Zibber, so... Yeah, it's pretty much just gonna reply in kind. What's Tracy?
Actually, can I lucky my attack roll?
If you have the feat lucky, yeah.
Reroll it.
OP!
Nope.
Still a miss. Alright. What's your armor class?
It is currently 12. Reroll that!
Lucky! Reroll it!
You have the unlucky feat?
I don't think that's a thing. Take 4 points of fire damage as he hits you with a fire.
It is on D&D Wiki.
I can make him. I get to roll another. He gets to roll another die.
You can choose. Designs. I have to roll
you
again.
You can't force the opponent to roll with a disadvantage.
And then chooser. The attack uses the attacker's roll or yours. Yeah, okay. That's another point of lucky you spent. That's cool.
Yeah, reroll.
Really?
Yeah, it's pretty OP.
It is OP.
Miss.
Time warps. It distorts around Cardiff.
And the firebolt misses. It looks like it strikes another Cardiff, like a ghostly visage of Cardiff that only you can see, Cardiff. And he looks like he killed you. And you see it, and you're like, oh. And you watch. You watch as you've died. Haunted.
A million times.
All right, it's your order. It's your turn. Are you? He shuts the door. Is the other thing that he does.
Okay, so the door's shut.
Sure is.
All right, I ain't no bitch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Open that door.
I wish I could see what was happening. Game is no fun when I'm just.
All right.
Look at the stream.
So,
don't have a battle map.
You...
Oh my god, the stream!
Yeah, the stream.
You have a battle map, don't you?
It's all dark, though.
We can't see it, because we're in the room down the hallway.
So you open the door, and you see the gnome pull and fidget at a candlestick or something on the side of this wall, and as he does so, the wall falls away. Chody and Dieter, the wall over here falls away, and you see a gnome.
He's bummed.
And he looks like he's very scared.
From right here. Go to sleep, bitch.
Roll. Oh, 32. Okay.
Good night.
Show me the area because it's 20 feet.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Right there.
Oh, you killed that roll.
Okay, so you're hitting it in the corner, so it catches him on the edge, and nobody else got it. Yep. He's unconscious.
Do we murder him?
How do I?
That's what Shadow would do.
And then I move one more square.
Where's Twitch?
All right.
And I want Gavin with me. I need my bird.
Good, you can talk to him.
I just looked at the. I hadn't read the Twitter stream chat, and the very first thing that Joe said, "Damn, Dieter's voice." I came.
When? What?
The very first thing on Twitter he typed was, "Damn."
Twitter?
Or not Twitter? Twitch. I did a mistake. Two TWI words.
Oh, sweet. I've got this feed up on the TV. Oh, this is gorgeous.
Smart. Okay.
Bind him. Bind it. Card. Tie it up.
Combat's over, unless you guys are wanting to kill it, so...
No, I want to interrogate the hell out of it.
But I mean, it's just sleeping, right? But that doesn't last forever, no?
Right, so you're tying him up, and then you guys are going to interrogate
him. I'll bind him. If it gets to me again, I'll start binding him with my rope.
Sure. Great. So we'll go ahead and move off of the battle map. And
I'm also going to apply tourniquets to his legs. Like...
Wow. You want him to lose a foot, right?
No. But I want it to be tight enough that his legs are like asleep and wobbly. So if he does some magic shit to get out of the bindings and he stands up to run away, he just immediately falls on his ass.
Nice.
All well and good. So,
Cardiff will, while he's tying him up, Cardiff's going to check his person for any type of food.
Okay, that's great. Aramil,
I'm going to keep an eye on anything that Cardiff doesn't take. Like, if he, like, drops a bunch of magic shit while he's looking for a biscuit, I'm going to be like, oh, I'll take that. Oh, cool, I'll take that. Oh, that's great,
I'll take the biscuit, please.
My assumption...
Shadow
was going
to mention to Cardiff that room that with all the stuff in it seemed to have food in it.
My assumption is that Cardiff, Malcolm... and Dugot are tying up the gnome.
No, I'm not.
What are you doing?
I'm watching. I messaged you.
Lock the door.
You messaged me where?
And the private server for the in the thingamajigger.
Discord?
Yeah, that one.
All I got was one line.
That's all it is.
Yep.
Half of our live stream is us learning how to use all this technology.
Basically every time we play, yeah. Okay, so you go back to the stairwell.
Shit, man.
All right.
How does the guys do it so professionally?
Aramil, what are you doing?
I'm going to go into the linen room.
Okay.
You say that was over.
The linen room?
And Tabaxi, you're helping with the tie-up, right?
Sure.
Chody, make a perception check. You can make an opportunity attack. Okay. You hear what sounds like a crick in the floorboard as you're kind of just standing there. It sounds like something steps next to you. My presumption is that you would attack something that steps next to you since you know where all your friends are.
Yes, I would.
You hit nothing. But nothing becomes a gnome, and a gnome becomes two halves as you split it in two with your axe.
I stare in just wide-eyed amazement.
There is a dead gnome laying on the floor in two parts next to you.
I stand up with my fists on my hips. Well, I guess we don't have to tie up that one. And I smile at God. For glory, am I right? And I raise one of my fists in the air.
This doesn't seem to be much of a challenge. They don't seem to be much of a threat. I don't see where the honor is in this.
Because you're a great warrior, clearly.
With that, he kind of eases a little bit and kind of goes, okay.
No, you're right.
Good thing we brought him.
We will be fast friends, and I clap him on the back.
All right. Dead
with
no.
That, he... So...
And then what do you do?
I'm going to kick the body around, look at the gnome, see if anything falls out.
Yeah, sure. So he looked like he was wearing a pretty sweet hat.
I'm gonna kick the left piece first and then the right piece second.
He looks like he was wearing a pretty sweet hat with like feathers kind of sticking out the sides of the wide-brimmed hat. He had a little rapier that he actually had drawn in his hand. Ooh. Looks like he was getting ready to stab somebody. Whatever clothing he was wearing is pretty much ruined. And it looks like he has a pouch on his belt.
Shadow would like that hat.
Are there biscuits?
Do you take the pouch?
I'll look at the pouch. I don't care about anything else.
Roll 3d10.
Can Shadow take the hat?
Yeah, I'm not even paying attention to anything else.
That's
wow.
That's the worst.
It's literally trash.
Wow.
He has 40 gold pieces in his pouch.
Oh, what? My gosh. So it could have been... Oh, my God.
This could is I why... lucky that?
No.
This no. is why I point by my character, because I can't roll worth anything.
All right. So that's sad. You guys are doing what with the gnome that is alive?
Well, gag it as well.
To save you the trouble, there's nothing in the linen room. Do you want to move on to another room that you're going to search? Sorry, Aramil. Sorry.
Oh, Aramil. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, I'm going to go look at the room with all the stuff in it.
Okay. Go ahead and make an investigation check for me. Everybody else tell me, go ahead, Andy, what were you going to do?
Oh, if he wasn't interested in the hat, I would definitely want to have the hat, and I want to follow Aramil.
It doesn't fit. It looks like it was made for a gnome.
That's cool. I'll take it anyway.
All right, you have a sweet looking hat.
Gnome right. hat.
You guys have the gnome. He's tied up. Do you wake him?
Did we find anything on his person while we were vigorously?
Since you're the one doing it, roll 3d10.
And if there's a biscuit or rations on him, I give it to.
He has 19 platinum.
I pocket them.
Okay. And he has a cute little rapier. And it looks like he has two strange devices. Looks like a weird kind of paper cone, like attached to arrows. Two of them.
A paper cone attached to arrows?
Like, the paper cone is the head, the arrowhead. They look like, basically, they look like rockets, like little bottle rockets.
Interesting. I pocket those, too.
All right, put two gnome rockets.
I don't know if I have a character sheet that I can edit. Hold on.
Is there anything special looking about the rapier?
No.
Okey-doke.
Can I add a note under my character section where...
Oh, and you guys would notice that this appears to be the room that the window with the tree outside of it is in this, the room that you're in. All right, so, and you don't really find much, buddy, John Schaff, but you find a book. That seems kind of interesting. Looks like it's kind of a journal with lots of pages torn out of it. Do you kind of look it over?
Yep.
It says at the very last page, which is the only page that's interesting. Yes, yes, my safe place in the sky. Oh, I must go there. I must go there. I will leave there. I will leave for there. And none will come to me. If they do, they will go to hell. They will all go to hell.
Okay. It's
written in Elvish.
I throw the book behind me and continue to search.
All right.
As if it had no value.
Yep. There's food, and it's kind of mostly either grains or spoiled. And nothing really much to it besides that.
Okay. I'll start to head back downstairs when that comes that time.
Sure. You guys wake up the gnome. He looks at you, kind of scared and frightened, and says something in gnomish.
Which I certainly do not speak. Is that considered a short rest? Can I spend a hit die?
It probably hasn't been an hour yet, no.
Okay.
Cardiff sits down on the corner and starts petting Gavin and kind of soothing him.
Tabaxi.
So I was in the room with all the stuff and with Aramil, is that right?
Not the room with all the stuff. No, you're in the guest room where the gnome was basically not. Are you following him? Are you following him?
I thought I did, but he searched the room and didn't find anything, which is okay. Fine.
Yeah, he's going through the stuff. Do you want to go through stuff as well?
Sure.
Make an investigation check. So he spent a little bit of time kind of looking over the that book and then threw it over his shoulder, kind of just shrugging. You kind of take it into your hand and kind of start looking it over. And you look up at the ceiling just as it's like, you know, as a point of order, and you see that there appears to be some sort of strange seam in one square of the ceiling. Looks like it might be like a secret door upwards.
Definitely would want to call the others over to look at this.
I immediately turn around and go back in.
Meanwhile, I believe Dieter was interrogating the gnome.
None of us speak gnomish.
Correct. So in character, I have all the charisma skills, and I'm trying to figure out of character, which one to use and what to say. I can try and use... Hold on.
What do you want? What do you want? He says in regular comments.
I can try and use...
Stop thinking about your skills. Just speak.
Like, well, yeah. Just... My character is more charismatic than I am.
So that's incorrect. There's nothing more charismatic than Dieter.
It is not exactly a one-for-one trade.
Dieter is the most sexiest man that I've ever met, so I don't know. You're short-selling yourself is what I think.
My wife agrees.
Yeah, ask that woman about what I was going to say, but just talk to him, and I'll tell you what you need to roll. Based on how you want to kind of address him. Like, I get what you're saying in your head, like what kind of path I want to go with, but just talk to him, figure it out.
So I'll kneel down on one knee and get my face real close to his and say something to the effect. So I take it this means there's no ghosts in this house.
Hey, you're right.
So you, what's left of that feller over there?
It's me and my
clan. Any more of you little bastards hiding around in the walls?
It's me and my clan. It's the Flicker Tinkles. What do you mean, other person? Did you find me, brother?
I look to my left at the pieces of body on the ground.
It's up in the, it's in the other room.
So. Oh, we moved him?
No, well, no. Chody butchered that one out in the stairwell. You guys are still in the guest room.
Yeah, he was like downstairs.
Yeah,
this guy had appeared in next to the fireplace.
He was trying to get upstairs, and he got butchered.
Well, we found another one that sort of looked like you. If y'all were twins, you're triplets now.
What you do to Duftar? What you do to Duftar?
I didn't do anything. My very large orcish friend, however.
You murderers. You're murderers.
Sure, you could call it that. I like to call it self-defense.
Just wait till the fellhoods hear about this.
Yes, okay, fine. Now, so I take it that means there were only two of you? What exactly were you protecting here?
Protecting? What?
You went into an awful lot of trouble to create the illusion that this house was haunted and that it had been abandoned?
No, I'm just trying to scare away people like you.
What are you scaring us away from?
From all the gold, you dunce.
Oh, so there's more gold to be found around here, is there?
More? You found any?
Huh? Is he telling the truth?
I don't know. You don't know either. Your insight passive is... He's not really deceiving.
My insight passive is bad.
Yeah, he's not really... It doesn't sound like he's lying. He just sounds like he's asking you, have you found any coin?
Only what I took off of you.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, yes. Enjoy.
How long have you been staying in this house?
I don't have to answer your questions.
I punch him in the face.
Roll an intimidation check. Yeah, so you slug him dead in the mouth and look at him sternly and just calmly ask your question again. About two six day.
Do I know out of character how long the house has been abandoned? When did the gnome disappear?
About a month. Month and a half. Alright, the Tabaxi and Aramil come into the room at about this point and they say, we found something, or whatever you want to say, Andy.
Yep. So there seems to be some sort of secret door in the ceiling.
Secret door in the ceiling? Hey. And he starts struggling at his binds. That's probably up there.
I slug him again.
All right, roll, nothing, actually. What's your strength modifier?
Zero. Oh, okay. Negative one. but I use my charisma for all my combat nonsense.
It's still enough, though. You hit him so hard in his jaw, you hear his teeth crack in his mouth, and he basically, his eyes roll into the back of his head.
Cardiff kind of shields Gavin from the violence.
Take that outside! Finish!
You dealt 2 points of damage with your punching. He had two.
Punch!
You're pretty sure that without, like, immediate, like, medical attention, he's a dead man.
Or still not. Got an arrow in his shoulder.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't really care if he's a dead man or not.
Alright, well, he's dead then.
I stand up and brush myself off again, and I look at, I think that was Airmail who said that, yes? Let's go check out that secret compartment, shall we?
You guys going up into it? You guys are climbing up into it?
We're going to check it for traps first.
The trap door does not have traps.
Really? Are you sure about that?
I'm pretty sure.
All right.
We did once in another game lose a very high-level character to a disintegrate spell that was glyphed onto a door that we decided not to check before we opened it.
Who's going up first?
I will.
Okay. All right, so once you get up there, you would see that the attic space has a vaulted ceiling all the way down the east and west to the east and west floors. So it's basically like vaulted up, very narrow space that you're climbing up into. In the center of the space, though, is a blackened steel cube that runs from floor to ceiling. On the north wall of the strange cube is a fireplace. The cube, you would notice, because you're pretty decently perceptive, it looks like there are small holes. Make a perception check.
Who's making the perception check?
This would be Shappy Shaff. You would see that there are pair of mad-looking eyes, like crazy-looking eyes, staring through the holes, watching you as you move around in the attic.
Oh, that's the gnome that used to live here. He's been hiding the whole time.
There's definitely something strange up here. I'll describe the cube, but I, in character, wouldn't have any idea anything about it.
You're yelling down. It's not a cube. It's like a steel wall.
Okay.
Basically, he's built a safe room in his attic.
So Cardiff went to the kitchen while they're doing that.
So wait, okay. At the top of the stairs, there's a door, or there's a hallway?
No, inside, there are no stairs. There's a trap door in the ceiling. When you get up there and, like, jump up into the ceiling, inside of that attic space, there is a walled-off room, 10 by 10, in the center of the attic space.
Okay.
We mean you no harm. We've taken care of the intruders.
Get out! Get out! You're the intruders! I'll kill you all! Get out!
Says a voice.
It's mine! Get out! It's mine!
And there's no notable, like, door or anything or any entry point that
there's
I can see?
There's a fireplace on the north side of this box. I'll go ahead and move you into the space so you can see it.
Is there a fire in the fireplace again?
This is the first fireplace that you've seen that does not have a fire in it.
If I were to move around the side, are there holes over here?
There's small little holes all throughout. He is watching you every step you take. As he moves around the room, is anybody going up after him?
Yeah, I'm going to pull myself up.
Okay.
I mean, I'm following the party, but I'm going to try and stand in the middle of not getting trapped by glyphs anymore.
Sure. And again, one at a time, because you guys are kind of climbing up. Okay. So you see the room as I've explained it. You're kind of moving around. As you kind of come up in, the gnome's eyes kind of move. Now he's jumping from, you know, hole to hole, watching the two of you. Get out! I say get out! I'll kill you all! I'll kill you all! It's not yours, it's mine!
What are you protecting in there?
It's mine! Shut up! Get out! Last warning, elf. Take your orc and get out.
The holes aren't big enough to shove anything through, like the point of a sword or anything, right?
Your sword wouldn't go through, no.
Okay.
An arrow probably wouldn't make it through either. There's a fireplace.
I'm gonna check out the fireplace.
Okay. So inside of the fireplace, you see what looks like a setting for like placing logs in, but it looks like the two sides look like they're kind of levers that could be pulled. So there's basically two levers inside, poorly disguised as where you would set a log to sit.
I smile and call down to the rest of the group. You might want to come up here.
Okay. So who's going up after these folks?
I assume that I can be third.
Okay.
So it was Aramel and then Dugat and then me.
Correct. And Cardiff is going to was going to the kitchen.
Yep.
When Shadow gets up and he sees like up the ladder and sees the room with their eye holes
There's
in it, right?
there are zero ladders.
Okay.
You are literally vaulting
Sorry.
yourself up off of the wall, is what's
Sorry,
happening.
sorry,
It's
sorry,
okay.
sorry.
It's the descent is the reason why that's going to be more of a problem.
So I basically when I see the their eye slits in the room, the steel room,
Yeah.
is it possible to get back down and then back up again?
Sure.
I'd want to grab that rapier that we found on the body.
You can tell that it will not fit.
Okay. Crap.
Literally, it is just narrow enough to see through. It is not wide enough for you to put the edge of a rapier, a arrowhead. Like if you were to take an arrow shaft and maybe shave it down a bit, you might be able to get it through. The only thing that could possibly get through would be like a needle.
Okay.
All right, so he's basically moving from eye hole to eye hole and watching each of you. And the orc is saying, come check this out to whoever's in the room, basically concerning the fireplace.
I have an idea, and I try to get back down out of the room.
Okay.
I have an idea too.
You leave the room.
So what if I just put this bonfire like
In the
underneath?
fireplace?
Just kidding, I'm not gonna do that. I'm getting food. But just saying. You
Oh,
know.
you mean cast through the hole? Like look in there and start to do that? Okay. So,
I'm not doing that.
to get a good visual to be able to see a target, you'd have to move up and put your eye at the hole. Are you going to do that?
Fuck no, I'm getting biscuits, man.
All
Do you
right,
have any?
you're downstairs. I can't even. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
All right.
I'm just curious. How would mechanics work?
You'd have to be able to see through it. And looking from a distance, you wouldn't be able to see a target. You'd have to be right up on it and look through, like he's
Okay.
doing.
Okay.
With my axe over my shoulder, I'm going to use my foot to go ahead and hit that switch.
Okay. Make a dexterity saving throw. All right. Okay.
I was dwelling
So
on the
go
fact
ahead
that.
and move yourself back one square. The hearth actually drops and forms a ramp down. You hear loud clashing and clattering and clanging and like bursting. And then the hearth slams back into its position. Like the bottom of the fireplace drops out and descends straight down like a ramp. You back away quick enough that you don't fall in, and then it slams right back into position.
I'm recalling the ending of the book since I was dwelling about the fact that I didn't realize that there was a ceiling slit.
Cardiff, as you're kind of like descending downstairs and heading to the kitchen, you hear this loud thud, 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 kind of slamming down from each of the floors, like one up above, one just above, and then one on the same floor that you're on.
Because it goes to the cellar.
I'm sorry, Gavin.
Get out! Get out! This is my house! No, it's coming from the attic.
Am I up there yet? Am I seeing this little weirdo hiding behind in the wall?
He's in that black box that you just typed about.
And the black box doesn't look like it's got any openings or anything?
Just very, very, very narrow holes that if you want to be able to see into the black box.
Yes, I see the narrow holes. Like, there's no seam where the box opens and closes?
No. Just a fireplace.
My friend, you see, there were some rather unsavory characters out here. We had heard rumors that the house was haunted, and we came in to dispatch the evil revenant. Real estate is at quite a premium in town these days. You see, refugees have been flooding in from Jether.
That doesn't matter to me. Get out! Get out! It's mine! Leave!
Well, is it yours? What is your name? You wouldn't be Crane by any chance.
Yes, Dorshak Crane. Get out!
Oh, all right. Well, Crane, you are correct. It is, in fact, your house. So why do you feel the need to hide in it or board it up? Why did you vanish? It is your house, after all. No one is challenging you there. I just find it very odd that you are hiding in your own house. What? Can you tell us what happened?
Get out of my
house. My God, man, you're...
Get out of my house. Get out of my house.
And have you gotten mad?
As he starts kind of chanting, get out of my house, get out of my house, get out of my house, the small little holes start to spring out green light that kind of floods the chamber a bit. And he starts kind of chanting, get out, and it starts to echo and resonate inside of the box.
Well, this seems like it's going nowhere. Do I feel like the green light is like a magical threat?
It definitely looks necrotic.
I will make my way back down out of the room.
Like, okay, well, I'll leave you alone.
All right, I'm getting out. I respect your personal space. We're here to help. Talk to me.
The light descends as your voice gets quieter. Anybody else doing anything up here? Aramil's already descended down. So has Malcolm. So just Tabaxi and the orc.
So just to reiterate.
You pulled one of the levers when you did. It sent the floor of the fireplace down at an angle that slid straight into the chute of the fireplaces below. And it all fell down is what you're assuming happened.
Okay, I'm going to try to step over and do the same thing to the other side and see if it does the same thing.
Make a dexterity saving throw. You pull yourself back away, and the same exact thing happens.
So, does it look like a travel thing, or does it look like a trap?
It looks like a trap.
Okay, cool. Then I'm going to go ahead and
descend back down. If I 30 or so foot fall. And neither one of the levers that you pulled opened a door for you.
Got it.
Yeah, okay.
What are you doing, Andy?
I'm just trying to understand. So two levers were pulled, and then...
Each individual lever was pulled, and when that happened, the floor fell out of the fireplace and created a ramp straight into the flue of all of the fireplaces that falls straight down through the building, down far from what it sounded like.
Andy, just recall the book.
What book? Sorry.
Book you picked up and read.
Oh, right.
You'll go to hell.
Mm-hmm.
Any cool ideas?
No, I don't. I think we need to go find a different way through.
Okay. So You guys are descending down. All right. That said, go ahead and everybody make me one investigation check.
Did I find any food?
No. Well, yeah, you would have found some in the room that they were just in. Rotted bread, old stale bread, and then lots of grains. Stuff you could definitely feed to a bird.
Fucking eating it too.
That's fine. Yeah, you got a bag of rice and you're just like doing this to it. All right. So, Chris, you pulled each one of the levers individually.
If you pull them together, it'll open the door.
Are you going to attempt that before you leave?
Sure.
Sounds all right. Good. I'm going to go ahead and move you, and it's just you, because everybody else has descended down. You pull both of the levers, and when you do, the back wall of the fireplace pulls open, and you see the gnome. And the gnome has just a feral-looking look on his face, and his fingernails have grown long from time. He's been in here for like a month and a half, and he just yells at you, "Ah!" And in one hand, he's holding this strange green emerald, which kind of pulses, and he kind of darts straight in at you and attacks you with his claw hand. It's weird-looking claws.
When he gets near me, I'm going to rage.
Okay, I'll allow it.
Can we hear any of this from below?
It should end quick, so don't worry about it.
Do initiative, or what are we doing here?
No. So does a 14 hit your armor class?
Nope.
Are you going to make an attack against him in retort?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. That'll hit. And did you add a +2 for rage?
I didn't know how to fix it, man. So it's fine. Gonna just add the 2.
So 10 damage. Okay, you hit him in the chest. He spirals back and away from you and slams into the wall, bleeding. And he looks at you with just sad eyes. Murderer! And he just dives right there.
I say,
what'd
okay.
you do?
Nobody knows what happened upstairs.
I'm going to move in and investigate the room.
There's a big pile of gold, a pot that looks like it's filled with shit and piss, and a chest. He appears to be wearing 2 rings, one on each ring finger, and he has a gem in his hand.
I try to clean up and take everything I can.
All right. It was pretty quick and quiet. Just him yelling like he was doing before anyways, and then a butchery. So there's a total of 530 gold pieces.
Woo!
There's definitely a sack available for you to fill that with. It has a symbol on it. It's an S with 2 lines through it. It's an arcane symbol. Very old, very ancient. The chest has a set of tools in it. That look like they are made of very fine materials. They look like gem cutters tools. And then there's the emerald. Do you try to take it?
So hold on a second. I have a 1 in Arcana. Would I see? Roll. Like I saw that green light.
Roll. No. You have no idea.
I just throw it in the bag.
All right. You snatch it up, chuck it in a bag. Cool deal. Except that you can't. You pick up the emerald and try and take it out of his hand. If you're taking the emerald, you're taking his arm or hand.
I will do that. I'll cut it off. I don't care. I'm a barbarian.
All right. You cut off his hand and you throw it and the emerald into the bag. So 530 gold pieces, 1 emerald, and 1 set of gem cutter's tools. Do you also want the pot and the 2 rings? Sorry.
Where do I actually put that out on the sheet?
So you see where it says equipment?
I see. Spell. Yeah.
Click the add button and then type each item out individually. Or if you're not personally going to keep it, you can type it out and put it in the notes. Party treasury.
Cool. I'll do that.
Cool deal.
So just type, where do I type it at?
In hit your party edit. Treasury, you type edit and you type it
and
in.
And then add it.
Okay. Simple
text box.
Simple stuff. You guys don't find anything else in the house. There doesn't appear to be any access to the cellar that you're imagining. And the clicking sounds like it's something really just horrid kind of living underneath the floorboards. So, did the Tabaxi, were you with Joe Orbic's group? No, you went out.
Nope.
You went out of the town. That's right. Okay, cool. So, that said, anything else that needs to be done in the house?
Wanted to check the other rooms in the kitchen.
Nothing.
Okay.
House is pretty much cleared with the stuff that you guys are able to find based on your investigation checks and your searching.
Dan, did you ever find food for your bird?
I did.
He did. Okay, so everybody gain 165 experience. Chody, you will be gaining 225 experience instead.
165 XP?
Yes, sir.
And just to be sure here, I found three rings or two rings?
Two rings. They look exactly the same.
Okay, I found two rings. The gem and the 500 gold, 500.
A gem, two rings, 530 gold pieces.
All right, cool. I have saved the changes and put them in the party treasury.
Okay. All right, and we will do a, so you are mentioning that you found the 530 gold to the party then?
I mentioned what I put in the party treasury.
Okay, so there are five of you. If you want to do a raw split, do it now.
We do that?
I mentioned what I put in the party treasury.
Oh, you kept what you kept.
Yeah.
100 gold.
He kept what he kept.
Green gem and a ring.
Green gem, one ring, because it's on the gnome hand. And you're a smart one. 100 gold and a gnome hand.
I want the gnome hand.
You have a scroll of identify. Dan, you want to identify one of the rings? The one in the party fund? Sure. It is a ring of sustenance.
Can I put it on? I don't have to be hungry anymore. I don't have to starve.
Do you take the ring? Do you guys let him take the ring?
Do you take this ring?
So you take the ring in place of the gold?
Fuck yeah.
Okay.
So then we each get 25 gold, and then the bastard who cheated us gets that whatever else he took.
And then the emerald is staying in the party fund?
Well, we don't know that he took a cut, so...
I'm here for honor. I don't need these menial things. You can have it.
Make a deception check, Chody.
What?
Make a deception check, Chody.
Roll deception.
You just lied, so make a deception check.
We know he's
lying. Goes,
Why do I suck at rolling?
Well, the thing is, that there's got to be more than 100 gold in this house.
He says it all boastfully. He says it all boastfully, like he intends it, but he's like, you know, definitely sounds like he's acting it up. He starts to sweat brow like a bit, and then he starts to walk forward, and you see a couple of coins drop onto the floor as he like scrambles to pick them up, and you can just hear him jingle jangling because he has 430 gold pieces in his britches.
You're gonna share that with us, right?
Hand over the rest.
I wink now.
The man said he had no additional funds. Trust him. He saved our lives more than once.
Why don't you walk out of here and let us handle this?
As you guys are making your way towards the door, you see that there's a man standing in the doorway. He's wearing a black cloak. He has a yellow shirt underneath. If you are not seeing my video and you are instead seeing my current image, That is the gentleman who's standing at the door. He just kind of looks you guys over, and he kind of smiles. And
Worm that walks is what we see?
Oh, is the worm that walks what I have right now? No. My personal Dupre image. If you're not watching my video, and you're seeing my image instead, my profile image, that's what you see. But I'll go ahead.
Maybe go in and change it.
No. I'll show you.
So we're splitting that money, right?
I say trust the orc.
BS.
Honorable man. Honorable.
So, knives out. Here we go.
Yeah, I draw my swords as well.
We're taking our share. What's the number?
Count, I will pull my
empty
ass
it
out
on the floor and count it out.
I'll pull my ass out.
All I see is the worm that walks.
Sleep in the room.
There you go. Go ahead and roll your dice for sleep.
22.
Okay. So maximum hit points go first. It will not affect the guy in the door frame. Next lowest. Highest. It lowest goes lowest first. Oh, sorry.
Yes.
So let's see.
I'm at 6.
Doing it around the people that are like, I'm not doing it at the door. I'm doing it like all the motherfuckers that are like,
Dieter.
That's just mine, yo.
You have 6.
That's just mine, yo.
Aramil, yeah. Were you contesting the money?
I was.
What's your hit points?
Currently 9.
9, okay. And then Chody, how many hit points do you have remaining?
10.
And Andy, how many hit points do you have remaining?
9.
So Dieter, you're unconscious.
Yep.
And...
not putting Dieter in it, no. Dieter's not arguing about money.
Oh, I thought
the
he
guys
was.
Guys that are pulling out their weapons.
Dieter's not arguing about...
No, Dieter's
about...
chill.
Okay, sorry.
Dieter's cool. Only the motherfuckers that are going to kill each other over money.
So Aramil and Shadow.
Aramil and Shadow pass out.
Should we coup de grace them?
No! As the two pass out...
what? They tried to mug you!
Hold on a
what
second.
What do you think they're going to do?
Hold on.
They're trying to mug me. They're trying to destroy
hold on a sec.
Here.
Hold on a sec. So the guy at the doorframe says, and he looks at you, says, honor among thieves... all of the time. And he looks at the half-orc and he says, I know you don't want to pay these gentlemen their cut, and that's fine. You can have that argument all you'd like, but I'm getting my 10% of the whole thing.
I always
get my cut. Kage told me that you were here, and I know approximately how much the man was worth.
I still don't know who this person is. I've never seen him before, never talked to him, never heard about him before.
So, you can pay me my 10%, or you can stay here forever.
What entitles you to 10%?
I gave you the job.
No one gave me the job.
Well, to be fair, I gave you the job, and he gave it to me.
I don't have a job here. I was just collecting my bird. I'll be leaving.
And the thief like looks at you and kind of gives you like a scan over as you walk towards the door, Cardiff, and he just lets you pass.
Nailed it.
How do I feel about him, John? Do I see him as a threat at all, or what?
He looks like he has a sword on his back and 2 daggers at his belt. He has a posture that seems so devil may care, it's making you angry. But based on just the way he looks like he's seen some fights by the scratches on his face, but you're not sure how competent he is. He looks like he's probably about the same size and build as Aramil is, but... he definitely looks like he's seen a bit more.
I don't know what I would do right now. He said 10%?
10% of the whole thing.
I'll give him a 200 and say this will be for the next time and walk by.
He kind of stops you and he says, where's the deed?
The rest is with them. I don't have that. This was my cut that I have.
He looks at everybody's response. He kind of steps over to the cat and very quickly kind of like just looks him over and then taps him with his foot. Walks over to the elf, taps him with his foot. No, no, you keep the money. And he kind of smiles. You didn't find it, did you?
A deed? No.
Be on your way.
I look at Malcolm and say, what deed? What this was supposed to be about honor. What deed is this?
I don't know what deed he's looking for. Presumably the deed to this house or something else. Maybe a gem mine. If this
he kind of smiles. Was a gem cutter. He kind of smiles and says, the house. He was a gem cutter. He wasn't a gem owner.
It's a house. It's been abandoned. Buy it from the city.
No, I'll just take it from the city. That's how thieves work. Feel free to leave. And he starts walking towards the stairs.
He said I could keep it.
The money, sure. It's yours. Make sure they get their cut.
Well, as once he hands the pouch back of the 200, I'm going to just throw it at the sleeping ones and let them have it when they wake up.
He woke them up.
He kicked them, yeah.
He did wake them up.
Okay, then I'll throw it.
You drop the coin and head out the house.
Yeah, I give 100 coins to Andy. I pick up the pouch, give Andy 100 coins, and I walk out as well.
All right.
So how many coins did we end up getting total at the end of that?
125 per person is what you should have had each. And then Chody would have had a little bit more because he's not discerning the total excess. But
yeah,
that's,
I would.
That's fine. He did most of the work in getting it, so.
I would drop another 100 at Dieter as well, since he was the one that got me the job.
Sure. So just make sure you're just kind of.
I'm at.
So does that mean 225 for me?
No, I out of the I gave the 200 to them. Yep. I gave you 100, and then I have 100.
Right.
I have 100.
Dan didn't get a cut.
Like, I don't need to eat ever again.
So then Shadow, Aramil up 100 gold. Dieter up 200 gold. And then Chody up to 150 gold. Or 130 gold.
Currently right now I'm at 180 from my starting gold.
Right. That's fine. Okay, good. We're all sorted?
Yep.
Okay. So a couple of things. I just want to be sure that once we get to the clearing of it, it's midnight 30 when it started. So it'll be midnight, well past midnight, well into the next day. One of you have already done a lot of walking and traveling, and we're probably tired through or possibly tired through this adventure. So I'm assuming you guys are going to room and board and sleeping. For my purposes, I am going to be the next one that posts. If anybody's watching at home and is thinking about posting for something, I will be the next one that posts, because Ian has basically thrown out a post that I think needs a bit more kind of focus that will kind of get everybody to a single point where you're pooling jobs instead of being forced into jobs. Organization-wise, the plan was whoever was the most active and wanted to participate would be the ones that kind of netted the first couple of things. But now the people who are just watching and waiting for their placement will have more opportunity to enter in. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and stop the stream. Thank you for watching. Any questions before I go?